Hi, I'm Jack Horton, and I'm an ESRI instructor, and I'm here to show you how to divide a parcel into equal parts. So, first let's make a record. You can name it as you need to. The record types are settable by you. We'll use split, and the recorded date is when it actually occurred in the legal record, not the date that you did the edit. So let's create that record, and now you can see there's an active record here. So let's use the divide tool. We'll select the parcel to divide, and then we can choose how to do it. We'll do proportional area and make each one the same size. Equal area if we know what size they are and we want to divide them up. Equal width if we have road frontages. So I'll choose the edge to set the direction. So I'll make it parallel to this edge. If I don't want it to be parallel, I could have actually typed in a bearing. So it wants to divide into two parts. I'm good with that. I could do more parts if I needed to. Let's go ahead and divide. So when we divide, notice it created historic parcels where the original parcel was, created a historic parcel where the original parcel was, and it created two new parcels. Now, notice it's going to update the labels in a minute, and when it does that, it will have divided the 7398 square feet up into equal parts. So, we'll give it just a second. It'll eventually realize it needs to update its labels. Now, another thing you're going to see when it does that update is we're going to get a bearing on this line that's going to be equal to this bearing, but it won't put a distance there because it doesn't know what distance to put. So notice I have in purple a bearing. The other bearings are in blue. That's because it doesn't have a distance. Purple means part of the COGO attributes are missing. So I have a way of dealing with that. Let's go ahead and select just that one line that needs to have the COGO values calculated for it. So I'll get just that line. And then there's a little tool called Update COGO. Let's bring up that tool. And it will calculate the distance based on the geometry. Now notice I can update the distance. I don't want to update the direction. That's already set. I'm happy with that direction. Let's update it. And it'll calculate the distance for us and put that value here on this line. And there it is. And notice it turned the bearing to blue because it is not incomplete now. All right, so that's how you easily split a parcel into two parts. Imagine doing this by hand. Notice the bearings and distances are different on the line. You have a curve to deal with, but it figured it out and it put them into two equal parts. All right. Thank you.